everyone! This is it! This is the place I saw! Come on then, the crystal ball should be in here.
Suppose there's nothing for it then. In we go.
Descendants of the great sages, a dire foe awaits you, and I would not have you meet with him unprepared. Now, hearken to my words. Among the many fiends in Rapthorn's service, one stands apart, a demon by the name of Juggaroth. By his hand, proud cities were razed to the ground, and countless innocent lives snuffed out. We encountered him shortly after the battle with Rapthorn, our wounds still fresh. It was a desperate struggle, but we mustered the last vestiges of our strength and wore him down, blow by blow, until victory seemed within our grasp. But try as we might, we could not destroy him. Worse, the final magic we cast upon him was not strong enough to seal him away for good. And so, he disappeared to lick his wounds, whither we did not know. We reasoned that his lair must be somewhere in the wild lands, but we could not find it. He is certain to return. Once his wounds have healed, he will break whatever remains of the seal we placed upon him, and all the world shall suffer. My children, should Juggaroth rise again, you must seek help. You will need powerful allies if you are to stop him. Now, at last, my duty as a great sage is done.
The Wildlands, he said, right? That'd be where we got the boat, I reckon. I don't remember seeing what's-his-name round there, mind. Probably worth having a butcher's, though, eh?
Thank you.
Those pesky sages! They dare turn me to stone! Me! To think of all the time I've wasted breaking their wretched seal! I sense a presence. Can it be? Has my lord returned already? Then there is no time to waste. I must take my rightful place at his side. Death to the humans! Death to the sages! Who are you? What are humans doing in my lair? If you have come to plead for your pathetic lives, you are going to be sorely disappointed. But your journey was not entirely wasted. You can amuse me until I crush those accursed sages once and for all! No! How could mere humans get the better of the great Juggernaut? Ha ha!
You really thought you had? Idiots! Idiots!
What's going on? Everything feels heavy all of a sudden.
Ha ha! Idiots! That is what you get for letting your guard down! Speaking of weakness, how does it feel to be crushed by your own weight? Oh, but do not fret! I am no monster! It shall be my pleasure to end your suffering in one fell swoop! What? My spell is broken!
Dear me, what a disappointment. You so nearly had it in the bag.
Marcello, what are you doing here?
More humans! Yeah, you creatures get everywhere! Just how big is your little party?
Oh, we're not together. Most certainly not.
No matter! You will die together! Prepare to suffer, you meddling little worm! Unlike the rest, I mean to kill you slowly!
I'm hearing a lot of talk, but not seeing much action. How about we dispense with the chatter, and you let me do what I came here to do, by which I mean, destroy you.
You dare to make light of me? I shall grind your bones into dust!
It seems he's finally ready to fight. Try not to get under my feet, will you?
Thank you.
Not again! Not again!
Why did you come here, Marcello?
To settle a score. Nothing more. You could have died in a ditch for all I cared, little brother. But not before my debt was repaid. And now it is.
Marcello! I thank you.
I really treasure these moments we get to spend together. I know how dangerous it will be to fight Rapthorn. I know you're risking your life for us. This could be the last chance we get to speak before the battle. Don't ever give up. The whole world is depending on you. But I'm happy that our fate is in your hands. Isn't it extraordinary that Marcello, of all people, came to our aid? I can safely say that our encounters with him until now did not leave me with a positive impression of the man. Quite the opposite, in fact. He imprisoned you. I didn't mention it at the time, but I noticed him following us when we came to the wasteland. Every now and then, he would stop and double over. I can't be certain, but I suspect the injury he sustained in Neos hasn't fully healed. Which makes me wonder, why would he take such pains to follow us like that? Perhaps he does care about Angelo after all. Could it be that all those things he said on the Holy Isle were just for show? I know that a lot has happened between them, but I wish those two could find it in themselves to make peace with one another. After all, they're the only family each of them has in this world.
Thank you.